And it just itches and burns. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Monday Night Raw live from Capital One Arena in downtown Washington, D.C. We're kicking things off tonight here with the Canuck Connection, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn. Kevin Owens tweeted out earlier this week. He's got something special planned here for the new general manager of Monday Night Raw, Chris Jericho. Can't wait to see what this is. It's below freezing outside, but it is hotter than hell in here. As we bring you Monday Night Raw once again from Capital One Arena, Washington, D.C. Kevin Owens, recently the Canuck Connection's been on a little bit of the wrong side of a losing streak. Hear what he's got to say here tonight. Kevin Owens just speaking about how much of a fan he is of Jericho and how he remembers watching Chris Jericho on Monday Nitro, WCW Monday Nitro, growing up. Recalls some of his best matches were when he was in that cruiserweight division. Sami Zayn professing his love for Chris Jericho as well. These two guys both grew up in Canada, obviously, same as Chris Jericho, and they definitely look up to him, but tonight, Owens says we're going to do a little throwback here. Owens, Kevin Owens pulled out a tape from the archives. Chris Jericho against Ultimo Dragon from WCW Monday Nitro 1998. This is a throwback. This is a nice little treat here. I didn't expect this. Wow. Looks like this is from the little time frame when Chris Jericho had his spat with Dean Malenko. Got the 1,004 holds on his tights there. Big splash off the top. Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn starting the show out tonight. Basically, like I said, their best friend, Chris Jericho, just recently came into the general manager position of Raw last week, taking over for Batista, who departed as his contract expired, and he's off to make some more movies. But Chris Jericho, no longer an active wrestler here on Raw while he's performing his general manager duties. But as I was saying, big moonsault off the top there. Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn have been having their fair share of troubles lately, especially with the New Day. But with Chris Jericho in the driver's seat of Raw, they're still... They still say things are looking up. They're expecting to get some huge opportunities from Chris, and they have it in with the boss, and that's never a bad thing. And like I said, they wanted to kick off tonight's show from the nation's capital. They wanted to kick it off with a bang, showing an old one of Chris Jericho's old highlight matches here from WCW Nitro back in 1998. I remember as a kid, as a teenager, Monday night was the biggest night in our house. You know, you had Monday Nitro starting at 8 o'clock at night on TNT, and that's usually when you would see these guys featured, the cruiserweights. They would be out there during the first hour of Nitro, just really getting the crowd excited and pumped up, and that's where Chris Jericho, he really took off in that WCW cruiserweight division with matches like this. And then, of course, 9 o'clock rolls around, and you just flip the channel over to USA for Raw. Monday Night Raw, as Vince McMahon called it back in the day. Big DDT there from the Dragon. Ultimo Dragon, he's been around quite a while. I mean, he was one of the top cruiserweights in the world at this time, back in the late 90s, early 2000s. He's well-versed, well-traveled around the world. I mean, he made a name in Japan and Mexico, and of course here in the U.S., he's got that arm wrench on Jericho there. Anytime you put these two in the ring, it should be a fun match. Personally, I think Jericho was a little underutilized in WCW. I would agree with that. He was kind of, again, he started out in that cruiserweight division, and his light shined, that's for sure. He had the spotlight, especially in this time when he was tangling with the likes of Dean Malenko, and he had the 1,004 holds gimmick with Ralphus. Dean Malenko was the man of 1,000 holds. But of course, Chris Jericho with his one-upsmanship, always the showman, he had to top Malenko, and he would bring out a list of all the wrestling holds that he knows, and you know, the arm bar and the monkey flips and Hurricane Ranas, and of course it topped Malenko at 1,004. So Chris Jericho loves that spotlight, that's for sure. But he was able to capitalize, and I believe this was around the time that he was the Cruiserweight champion as well. Ultimo Dragon just slammed him on the edge of that apron there. It's always fun to go back and watch the old school stuff like this. Jericho! Oh! Chris Jericho is going to be singing tenor for a while after that. Man, he got hung up on those ropes. He played it off like a pro. But, of course, back in the earlier days, Jericho was not as technically sound as he is now. Made a bit of a mistake there. Looks like he's setting something up. He's got Ultimo Dragon on the announce table with Tony Schiavone and Bobby the Brain over there at the other one. Rest in peace, Bobby. What? Big moonsault! Holy cow! Chris Jericho with a moonsault from the ring to the outside! Put the Ultimo Dragon through the announce table. Man, I'm sure Heenan had something to say about that. Again, rest in peace, Bobby the Brain Heenan, voice of my childhood, man. Just being able to still go back and watch these old Nitros, that's a special treat, definitely. If you're interested in watching Monday Nitro, go ahead and sign up for the WWE Network. It's only $9.99 a month, as we all know, but they have plenty of WCW stock on there. Chris Jericho lounging over in their corner. He's never been short on confidence, that's for sure. He's always begged for that spotlight. I mean, he was destined to be a star. Even watching him back then, during this time, I mean, real wrestling fans, they could have picked him out of a lineup. They knew he was going to be big. Like moves like that, the Lion Salt. Man, he put away some legends with that move. Looks like, oh! Thought he was going to say, looks like he added another there with Ultimo Dragon, but Dragon was able to kick out. Jericho. Oh, look at the Jericho with the old school Lion Tamer. He's got that knee in the back of Dragon's head. He's got it planted. That neck is bent. Ultimo Dragon has to tap out. Chris Jericho with an impressive throwback victory here over the Ultimo Dragon. And you know what? I got to give it to Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn here. You might not always agree with their tactics or their personality or their style, but I give them credit here. They busted out a pretty cool idea with the throwback match. Kevin Owens also alluded to the fact that this will not be the only throwback. They're going to pay tribute to Chris Jericho in the upcoming weeks with some old school footage and some old school matches. So that ought to be fun to watch. Keep your eye out for that. I'm certainly going to enjoy this tribute to the Raw General Manager, that's for sure. Hell of a first match there. Jericho picked up the victory over the Dragon. I'm sure he was heading into a match with Dean Malenko, the man of 1,004 holds, the Raw General Manager. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We are coming to you live from Capital One Arena in downtown Washington, D.C. And we have a special show lined up for you tonight. Later on, we'll be seeing AJ Styles versus Randy Orton, the rematch. This time, however, there will be no disqualifications, no holds barred, no countouts. That ought to be a hell of a showing after the match they put on last week. Right now, Kofi Kingston's going to be in action in a Royal Rumble qualifying match. He's going to be taking on Rhino. No easy task there. Kofi Kingston and the New Day got to be walking on sunshine the last few weeks with all the damage they've seemed to do over Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn. The Canuck connection. New Day is going to be well represented in the Rumble here if Kofi can pick up this victory. As last week, Big E was able to get that upset victory over Kevin Owens, and was a hell of a match. I gotta give both competitors credit there, but somehow Big E was able to come out on top, and he won a spot in the Royal Rumble. And again, if Kofi can pick up a victory over Rhino here tonight, some good show of respect right there between these two. Kofi can pick up a victory. Like I said, you're going to have New Day very well represented in the Royal Rumble. What a hell of a way to start a match right there. Kofi just ran out and jumped on Rhino, followed it up with an elbow drop from the top. My goodness. Tell me he doesn't want to be entered into that Rumble. I'm sure Kofi doesn't care if he goes number 1 or 15 or 30. Oh, man, another mushroom stomp. Kofi Kingston, man, he's had some Royal Rumble moments, hadn't he? I've never seen anybody innovate the things that he has in that Royal Rumble match. He's really made that something special every time he's in there. But this year, like I said, if he can get past Rhino tonight, I'm sure he's going to be focused on winning the whole thing this year and maybe possibly headlining WrestleMania. Rhino with a big knee. Rhino's got his own little story going on here. He came into Monday Night Raw a few months ago with Rob Van Dam. What is that? Rhino was getting up, and Kofi was able to jump on him and roll him up into a victory roll there, into a crucifix. Rhino kicked out. It was a hell of a mid-air adjustment there by Kofi. But Rhino, he started out teaming up with RVD. Looks like they were kind of on a comeback trail. It was, you know, two old dogs. We just saw a match from the late 90s, and Rhino's been around. He was around in ECW back then with RVD, tearing it up, and they wanted to, wait a minute, we got to cover. One, two. Looks like Rhino and RVD wanted to make a comeback and enter the tag team division, and RVD unfortunately suffered an injury. It was a pretty severe concussion that's kept him out for the last few months, and unfortunately there's no word on when or if he'll be returning to Raw. So Rhino has decided to interject himself into some singles competition here, but Kofi's got him lined up. Trouble in paradise! Trouble in Rhino's paradise! This is not the way you want to start your singles career on Raw. Kofi King. Oh! Rhino kicked out, though! He was able to get that shoulder up. Kofi Kingston with a big trouble in paradise. It's, like I said, it's not a strong showing here, but Rhino, he's got that weight advantage. Again, if Rhino can win this match and get entered into the Rumble, big overhead belly to belly, he's not going to be an easy guy to eliminate, that's for sure. Those big tree trunk legs and that body. Gore! Rhino with the gore on Kofi, that's it. Well, Kofi was able to kick out of that, though. I guess Rhino hasn't done enough damage. But that's a big man. That is a man beast. Again, if he can get into that Rumble, if he can get past Kofi Kingston and the New Day here tonight, Rhino's got to be odds got to be in his favor in that Rumble match. Gets back in the ring here, but he gets taken out right away by Kofi. So both guys really have a lot on the line here. I mean, you obviously always want to be advancing up the ladder here in WWE, but with that Royal Rumble match on the line, that's a good way to skyrocket yourself to the top. Speaking of going to the top, Rhino on the middle rope. Oh, he went for that big splash, but he missed. New Day? Kofi. Big time. Stomping. He's got the momentum here. Picks him up, but Rhino flips him over his shoulder. Kofi has to roll out. He's in a little bit of trouble here. He's got to discuss things with Big E. Once again, Big E has also locked up his spot for the Royal Rumble. He will be entered into that. Big E has a chance to come out of that on top and headline WrestleMania for that Universal Championship. And again, he wouldn't mind having his buddy, having a little bit of backup in there with him, Kofi Kingston. What's he doing? He's going to the top. Kofi, what are you thinking? Kofi with a big fist drop to the outside. My goodness. Delivering, putting the boots to Rhino now.
And Byron, he's still down after that one.
Yeah, that did some big-time damage, Michael.
Kofi just playing to the crowd up a little bit here. Rhino's got to get back on track. Like I said, he's looking to really kind of rebound and come back into the singles division. And hopefully, like I said, if he can get into that Rumble and have a good showing or possibly win it. Monkey flip there. Kofi with the speed. The catapult into a springboard crossbody. One, two, three. Rhino's not able to kick out. Kofi Kingston with the victory. Kofi Kingston pulled the victory out right there. Like I said, he used his speed against power. 9 out of 10 times, speed's going to win that. Moves like that right there. Just able to adjust in midair and catch Rhino in that crucifix pin. Wasn't enough to put him away, but big trouble in paradise there. Rhino had a lot of fight in him, but just also showing a little bit of ring rust on him too, so maybe he can get his act together in the next few weeks, and we'll have to see. But tonight, like I said, it's going to be a New Day party. New Day and Big E will be, I'm sorry, Kofi Kingston and Big E will be representing the New Day in the Royal Rumble this Sunday night from Philadelphia. Booty-o's for everybody. Booty, booty, booty. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to focus our attention on the rematch here, Randy Orton and AJ Styles. Again, to recap, last week these two had just one hell of a match against each other. I mean, these guys, Randy Orton threw everything that he had at AJ Styles, but he, for whatever reason, he couldn't put him away. He couldn't defeat AJ Styles. He hit him with a number of RKOs. He hit him with 4 or 5 rope-hung DDTs. I mean, he even, at one point, he struck AJ with a sledgehammer on a number of times. Like I said, Randy Orton, he just, whatever he did, he just couldn't put AJ away. He couldn't keep him down for that 3 count. He couldn't get that straight-up victory over AJ Styles. So, Randy Orton, I mean, he, just like a human being, he got frustrated and he turned his attention to the referee and kind of put a beating on the referee, which we don't really we don't condone that at all here in WWE, but I'm sure he'll be facing some fines for that. But he actually tossed the referee out of the ring and then proceeded to go right back to AJ with that sledgehammer, and that's when the new Raw General Manager, Chris Jericho, showed up on the Titantron and said, "That's enough, just for the safety of everyone in ringside, called the match off and said they're going to have a no DQ, no holds barred match here tonight. Looks like Randy Orton, I don't know what he's doing. AJ Styles, oh, Randy Orton just caught AJ. AJ, we had the arena lights out and the spotlight in AJ's face. I guess he couldn't see Orton coming up the ramp. Orton just blindsided him with a clothesline. Not even letting him get to the ring. And there has been some animosity building between these two in the last few weeks. Again, this really just began as a rankings type rivalry. Randy Orton, he's been the top dog for a long time. Again, he's the youngest WWE champion in history. He's a legend killer. He's beaten everybody, from Cena to Mick Foley to The Undertaker. He's beaten everybody. So, I mean, he's the man. And then to have AJ Styles come in here and just put on the caliber matches that he's put on, and the fan following that AJ has garnered, Orton got a little bit jealous about that, a little upset. See, he's got AJ up now. What is he doing? Oh, he just slammed him into the wall. He just slammed. Oh, and he powerbombed him on the stage. That is steel. There is no give on that stage. But Randy Orton seemed to be a little threatened by AJ Styles' presence here on Raw. And he's brought his A game to the phenomenal one. I mean, I've seen AJ locked in some battles, but I don't know if he's ever been in there with anybody quite as dangerous. Oh my gosh! Just slammed him down again. You can see AJ's got those ribs taped up from those sledgehammer shots last week. Looks like Randy Orton's done with this. He's heading backstage. AJ's getting up and following him. Keep the cameras on him. We finally got a camera back there. It looks like these two are butting heads in the gorilla position. AJ followed Orton backstage. It looked like Orton was done with this match, but AJ wasn't quite. Again, you see AJ, he's pretty bandaged up here. He's got the taped ribs from results of those sledgehammer shots last week. Oh, he's going to need more tape. Oh, get him some more medical tape because he just got put through a table. Orton's got that chair. Oh, you also notice AJ's got his head wrapped up there. He did have to have stitches last week after the match. I'm going to fast forward ahead a little bit there, and you see Randy Orton taking it to AJ with the fire extinguisher and adding insult to injury there. But like I said, AJ had to receive some stitches after last week's match. He's got some bruised ribs. Nothing broken. He's just kind of banged up. Little bit of damage here and there, but this guy is a warrior. The fight that he put up last week was ridiculous. These two, I don't know. Anytime you put these two together, it's fireworks, that's for sure. I mean, look where they are right now. This match is not in the ring. This match is not even on the ring. This is not ringside at all. This is the catering area. These two are out of control. They have fought all the way back to the catering area. And I don't know if I'm the only one that notices this or not, but it doesn't seem like anybody's in a big hurry to step in between these guys. I don't see any security. I don't see any other superstars or referees or anybody trying to stop this. Randy Orton just slams him down on the concrete. And AJ's well-being. I mean, I don't know. Chris Jericho, again, I give him a lot of credit. I like the idea of having these two in a rematch and possibly finishing what they started and having a clear-cut winner, but with a major event coming, we're gonna skip forward a little bit. Looks like they made their way back out to the arena here. With a major event like the Royal Rumble coming up in less than a week, I don't know how smart this was to put these two guys in a match like this. Not only that, I don't know how smart it was for these two guys to accept a match like this. Orton! Holy God! Orton just threw AJ off the stage. Oh, and then he... Big splash! Orton just threw AJ off the stage like a bag of garbage and then just followed it up with a big splash. These two guys are just all over Capital One Arena tonight. Goodness. Can Washington, D.C., we gotta call the National Guard in on this one. Right up the street here. Get some Secret Service, some presidential security in here, because this is out of control. Big kick to the gut. Looks like Orton's heading back to, hopefully back to the ring and get this match under control. This is ridiculous. Big shot to the face rocks AJ. And a headbutt to the back of the head. AJ Styles is no worse for the wear here. He's, again, I mean, he's not suffering any signs of a concussion. He's got some bruised ribs, but that's nothing he can't handle. I mean, I'm sure it's... Oh, my God. Shots like that aren't going to help. I'm sure it's a little painful to breathe, but... You're out here against Randy Orton. You got to be at the top of your game. You got that adrenaline going. Orton's got that... Oh, Orton just smacked that kendo stick across AJ's face. Holy... Nah, these guys aren't holding anything back here. AJ throws Orton into the corner of that table. This is getting rough. They're out here amongst the crowd. We barely are able to get that spotlight on them, but I don't think these guys care where they are as long as they're beating the crap out of each other. Doesn't matter. Orton's got some evil intentions here. He's got AJ up again. He puts him through another table. He put AJ Styles through another table with a powerbomb. That's the second table he's gone through tonight. Oh, and you can see the damage. AJ is hurt. Big stomp to the back there. Randy Orton, I mean, he is the definition of merciless. Cold, calculating. I don't know if you've been following SmackDown, but it seems like lately there's a lot of chaos here in the WWE. Last week with Orton attacking the referee and going wild on AJ, and then last week on SmackDown, Curtis Axel seemed like he had a psychotic episode, and he just laid into a referee. But if you haven't seen that, if you haven't seen last week's SmackDown, go back and check that out. I have never seen anybody do anything like that to a referee in my life. That was, I don't mean to laugh. I'm not trying to make light of it. It's a serious situation. I mean, you know, that guy had a, guy's got a family just like the rest of us, and you know, I just, I don't mean to make light of it, but it was a very interesting piece of activity that went down. AJ with a nice chop block there, climbing up on the trunk. Yeah, but he had second thoughts. Maybe his ribs are bothering him a little bit. Thought AJ was going to jump off of that trunk and pull out some of the high-flying moves, but he thought better of that. But he's still got Orton under control here. But it seems like the general managers, Chris Jericho and Jax L, I mean, these guys have got to get things under control. Like I said, you got guys like Randy Orton out here. He's throwing referees out of the ring. He's hitting other guys with sledgehammers. You got Curtis Axel beating up referees in the back. I mean, it's just, we can't have that going on here in WWE. We have to maintain some sort of order. So Orton with a big slingshot there. Chris Jericho's got a lot on his plate here. Oh, an RKO out of nowhere. Out of nowhere. That's going to be it. AJ, no. AJ Styles rolled his shoulder up a little bit, the ref said. Huh. Orton is in full control right now. He throws AJ up in the air. We saw that last week, too. Orton just throwing AJ up into the lights and just letting him land on those ribs. That's not a bad game plan. What has he got in mind here? Probably big suplex. Orton's going to the outside. What is he doing? Look at the blood pouring out of AJ. My God! Oh, my God! Randy Orton just suplexed AJ Styles to the outside, to the arena floor. There is no give on that floor, but AJ somehow able to slam Orton into that barricade. The fight, this guy does not quit. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. A Styles Clash on the outside. Randy Orton just felt the Styles Clash, but he sends AJ into the steps. This is unbelievable, this match. I didn't think there was any way these two could follow up last week, but it looks like, Elias, these guys just hate each other all of a sudden. Orton just slammed him through the barricade. For the second week in a row, AJ Styles has been speared through the barricade. Look at him leaning on the steps. He is broken. AJ Styles is just gushing blood out of those stitches. Ribs are taped up. He's barely moving. But he does continue to fight. He just keeps coming at you. He's got those Energizer batteries in him somewhere. He just keeps coming at you. A big boot to the gut there. Orton was waiting for him on that one. He got up in that powerbomb position. Oh! Oh, my God. A splat on the floor. Orton just powerbombed AJ into the ring post and then chucked him down on the floor. Goodness. AJ's able to slip out and give him a reverse DDT. AJ's might be mounting an offensive here. He throws Orton into the steps. Follows it up with a big clothesline. Doesn't look like it caught him very well. that says it all. AJ might have some blood in his eyes there. His vision's going to be affected a little bit. He stomps on Orton's arm. Like I said, AJ Styles looks like those stitches got busted open again, and he's still putting up a fight here, though. This guy is all heart. I mean, if AJ Styles comes out in that Royal Rumble on Sunday night, the crowd is going to just erupt. This is one of the most beloved superstars in the WWE, on the planet. I mean, you talk about one of the best wrestlers in the world right now. Orton goes for that RKO. AJ able to slip out. AJ, Orton blocked a punch and follows up with one of his own. Throws AJ into the ropes. Say it with me. Vintage DDT. Vintage Randy Orton. Oh my God, that might be it. One, two. AJ's able to kick out of that. Like I was saying, you talk about the best in the world. Orton looks like he's going after the ref here. I mean, I don't blame him. What do you got to do to keep this guy down? Orton's just pacing around the ring right now. Just kind of looks like he's just lost in thought. He just doesn't know where to go now. What else can you hit this guy with and hope to keep him down? AJ's fighting back. Big fireman's carry reverse there from Orton. I honestly believe AJ Styles is considered the best in the world right now. I mean, you talk about your Kenny Omegas and your Kazuchika Okada and Tetsuya Naito. I mean, AJ Styles is the best in the world. He can hang with any one of those guys right now, just like he's hanging with Orton. Oh, look at that. Big time. AJ Styles, go for the cover. AJ Styles. He couldn't get the one count even. He's going to have to do a little bit more damage there. Got him in that dragon sleeper. Follows it up with a slam. Orton's on the ropes. He has to roll out of the ring. AJ in pursuit. Orton rolls back in. He's waiting for him. He whips AJ into the ropes and sends him up into the lights again. Jeez. How much more can AJ Styles take? Not only that, but if you're Randy Orton, what do you do? What can you possibly do? He's done everything. He has done everything you can think of to AJ Styles, and he still can't pick up the victory. And look at this right here is a good example. AJ is able to lock in that calf killer. Orton might have to tap. Orton, oh my God, is doing a lot of damage. Orton, oh my God, he was so close to tapping out. He's fighting back. Randy Orton, he's got to get to those ropes. He's got to break the hold or something. Oh, that'll do it. Big elbow to the back of AJ's head, and we know the damage that's been suffered over the last few weeks to that head. Look at AJ Styles. Another vintage DDT. AJ Styles is just gushing blood right now. All that heart, all that blood that's pumping out of the heart. That's it. RKO. That's it. One, two, three. What? AJ got that right shoulder up again. Orton goes for another cover. One, two. AJ kicks out again. AJ Styles. I've never seen anything like this in my life. Over the course of the last 2 weeks, this guy has just been in a war. He's been hit with everything. Randy Orton still can't keep him down, still can't beat him. You're not going to win many matches absorbing punishment. AJ follows it up with a big uppercut here. Oh, but a kick to the gut. Orton's in control with that Olympic slam. Orton. He might just be out, guys. He's going to have to call in some heavies to beat AJ. I mean, this is just another RKO. That has got to be it. Randy Orton finally gets his victory. What the? What in the hell? AJ Styles kicked out of that? Orton is going crazy right now. How in God's name? Clothesline. Big clothesline. A duck under, and Orton follows it up with that snap power slam. What is he doing? Orton looks like he's got something on his mind. What is he thinking? Oh, no. Randy, no. This is... Oh, my God! Randy Orton! What did we just see? Look at this! A punt kick! Oh! Straight to the temple of AJ Styles! Randy Orton! Knowing full well this is a no-holds-barred match and he will not pay the price for using that move tonight, as all is legal. AJ's still able to kick out. AJ Styles was still able to kick out of that punt kick. We haven't seen Randy Orton use that move in years. Unbelievable. AJ hits him with a Pele. AJ hits Orton. How is Randy Orton in any trouble right now after what we've just seen? The punt kick to AJ Styles, who has already suffered massive amounts of damage, wasn't enough to put him away. Orton lifts him up on that turnbuckle. What else can you do to this guy? I'm still in shock over the punt kick. It banned in WWE, but again, this is a no-holds-barred match, and Orton's going for the finish. Orton hits the RKO from the top. AJ Styles is lifeless. Orton is exhausted. Ladies and gentlemen, this is unbelievable. Randy goes for that cover. AJ's out. One, two, three, that's it. That is Randy Orton finally picks up a victory over AJ Styles. And my God, the quality of matches that we're seeing out of these two. I mean, I hate to say, I want to see him go at it again. Just, I mean, in an ideal world, I would like AJ Styles to get healthy and then maybe see them go at it again. But we know damn well both of these guys are going to be entered into the Royal Rumble here in 6 days. And God help them if they're in there together at the same time. I don't even know what to say. Randy Orton pulled out the punt kick tonight. Again, a banned move here in the WWE, but being a no-holds-barred match, all is legal. And it looks like it was enough to put AJ away, but we're going to have to get some medical professionals to check on AJ, because he took a hell of a beating over the last 2 weeks. But right there, you see Randy Orton coming for that Universal Championship. Will he be the Royal Rumble winner? We'll see Sunday night. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. And welcome back to Monday Night Raw, live from Capital One Arena in Washington, D.C., If you're just joining us, I feel really sorry for you, because you just missed one hell of a showing from Randy Orton. Picking up a no DQ, no falls count anywhere victory over AJ Styles. My God, what a hell of a match. But right now, we're going to hear from Aleister Black. Last week after his match, he was confronted by Drew McIntyre. No words were shared, but Drew McIntyre just pie-faced the Intercontinental Champion, sending a message. Speaking of Drew McIntyre, what in the hell? Drew McIntyre, oh, he's attacking Aleister Black with a chair. This is not a match. Aleister Black was out here to say a few words about his match this Sunday against Drew, but I'm sure he was going to address Drew's actions last week as well. But McIntyre's not giving him the opportunity to even get to the ring. Drew McIntyre just attacking Aleister Black from behind with a chair. Now he's taking apart our announce table over here. This is, what is he doing? Aleister, Drew just lunges and grabs him there. He's got some, Drew's got an idea. Drew knows what he wants to do. I mean, this is not necessary. This is just, I think I know what Drew McIntyre is doing. He knows he's got a tough match for the Intercontinental Championship Sunday. Very tough competitor in Aleister Black. Oh my God. The Future Shock! Drew McIntyre just delivered the Future Shock to Aleister Black on the announce table. obviously trying to not only send a message to him, but maybe even soften him up before the match. This is just not necessary, though. These are two of the best up-and-comers we have here on Raw. Just having them in the match for the Intercontinental title was enough, but now it's getting a little personal. Drew McIntyre, oh my God! He's just smacking Aleister Black with that Intercontinental Championship. Hit him in the back of the head. Aleister's fighting back, though. This is the type of challenge that Drew's going to have to face on Sunday. Has anybody noticed? I mean, do we have security in this building? Are they all protecting Trump? Do we have security? Do we have referees? Anybody wanting to break this up? Anybody wanting to step in here? This is ridiculous. We saw Randy Orton and AJ Styles fight all over the arena earlier tonight. And I mean, at least that was a sanctioned match. This is just an attack by Drew McIntyre. Delivers a huge headbutt to Aleister. Aleister Black's not going to back down, though. He's going to take on all comers. Drew just plants him down. Oh, my God, on that stage. Drew McIntyre's obviously trying to soften Aleister Black up for Sunday night. He wants that Intercontinental Championship. Oh, and he wants it bad. Oh, my goodness. He just slammed Aleister Black into the LED display. Followed it up with a powerbomb on the steel ramp. The stage, I should say. Now he's got Aleister lined up. This is despicable. Another future shock. We got to get some medical attention out here for Aleister Black. God, the medical staff's going to be busy tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we change gears here, and we're going to get into Ruby Riott taking on Carmella, the returning Carmella. We all know Ruby Riott lately has been having her issues with Nikki Bella, but it seems she was able to squash that last week with a victory over Nikki. Tonight she sets her sights on the returning Carmella. Carmella made her return to Monday Night Raw last week in a match that she wasn't even scheduled in. Becky Lynch was scheduled to go up against Natalya, but the week prior to last week, Becky Lynch did so much damage to Natalya's arm that Natalya wasn't able to compete, so she brought in a replacement in Carmella. Carmella with an impressive return victory over Becky Lynch last week. I guess in Becky's defense, like I said, when you can't prepare for an opponent, you don't know who you're going to be facing. The odds are not in your favor to win that match, especially at the level of competition we have here on Raw. Carmella was able to come in here and pretty much handle her business against Becky and get that victory. And what I refer to as an upset victory, and I stand by that, no offense to Carmella, but she's got a long way to go here in the WWE, and a win over Ruby Riott tonight would be a fantastic start. Both of these women, Ruby Riott's still a little new to the brand as well. Again, she came in here having issues with Nikki Bella and the whole diva's outlook on life. Just getting things because of who you know or because of how pretty you are or who your boyfriend is. And Ruby Riott's not about that life. She's about there. She's about going out and earning it the hard way. So she really took it to the house there, took the house to Nikki Bella last week. And again, she was able to pick up the victory, and that should be the last we see of those two. But again, you always got to move forward, so Ruby Riott and Carmella both are looking to climb the ranks here in WWE in the women's division, as Ruby Riott climbs the turnbuckle. But like I said, I mean, it's highly possible both of these women will be in the Women's Royal Rumble on Sunday, the first ever Women's Royal Rumble. And again, a victory, that's anybody's match, you know? I mean, it all depends on your number. It all depends on where you come out. It all depends on who's in there with you. Anything can happen in a Royal Rumble match. We know that. You could be looking at the winner of the first ever Royal Rumble in Ruby Riott or Carmella. And if that happens, again, yes, they will automatically, the winner is automatically granted a title shot. Oh! So again, even though Ruby Riott's a little new to the brand and Carmella's kind of still trying to make a name for herself as well, both of these women could have a chance for a title shot here soon if they're able to win that Royal Rumble. Ruby's got her up on the top here. What's she thinking? She got her in that back suplex position. That's a long way. Oh, man! That's a long way to fall. Carmella ends up in the middle of the ring. Ruby Riott, I'm impressed with her so far, what I've seen out of her. She is a tough competitor. Oh, she kicked Carmella in the back, but she took it. Carmella is not to be taken lightly either. Luthez press, followed up some right hands. A lot of speculation on Carmella's return. We don't know, don't necessarily know if she's going to be aligned with the family. We do know her history with Big Cass and Enzo, obviously, and she's wearing the colors of the family, but we don't know. I mean, having them in her back pocket, that would be a huge advantage, being the princess of the family. That would be quite the accomplishment for her. She's kind of getting handled right now on the outside, though. Ruby Riott is a tough, tough competitor. This is going to be a challenge for Carmella. Like I said, I don't think she got lucky last week. I'm not saying she got a lucky win. Oh, right there you see an example of what she can do. Carmella's got some skills. Oh, she just paintbrushed Riott with a slap there. Slams her face into the mat. Carmella's showing a little bit of an aggressive side here. Like I said, she's got some skill. I'm not saying she got lucky last week against Becky, but I do consider that an upset, and I'm sure Becky Lynch wasn't happy about it, but we'll see if anything plays out as a result of that. Ruby's whipped into the corner here. And monkey flipped. Oh, but she's able to counter and land on her feet. And she sends Carmella into the turnbuckle. What an impressive move there by Ruby. Shoulder block. That one hurt. Off the ropes and a super kick. Oh, we saw this last week against Nikki Bella. Ruby Riott with a super kick barrage. Bang! Right in the schnoz. Carmella's in some trouble here. Ruby Riott sets her up. And the Riott kick. That might be it. That might do it. Thank you for coming, Carmella. Girl, you got a long way to go. One, two, three. Ruby Riott and looking very impressive here tonight against Carmella. She has a good shot to win that. Well, wait a minute. Nikki Bella's here. Nikki Bella apparently is not finished with Ruby Riott. She is not happy with that loss she suffered last week. She doesn't seem to be in too much of a hurry to get down to the ring there. Ruby Riott's closing the gap, though. Ruby Riott's approaching her up the ramp. Some words being exchanged. What? Ruby. Oh, here we go. Ruby Riott fires away. Nikki Bella. Here we go. Oh, no. Now security shows up. Where were these guys the whole show? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have to take a quick commercial break. Be sure to join us for Raw Part 2 live from Washington, D.C.